So this is a cool design that you can download and print. And while the build is a little on the complicated side, it is the foundation of how I'm building a lot of my robots currently. And I also just one-upped this design a little bit. So it's a pulley drive with a steel cable. And the steel cables run through this square channel here. You can see them there poking out a little bit. And so when you move one of these, the other one moves, right? And this allows you to get action at a distance. It's a reasonably sturdy drive mechanism. And because it's running with cables, I can do stupid things like that, giving me kind of a wrist action that allows it to rotate or just be goofed up in some stupid way, and it still works pretty well. Let me demonstrate how this thing is put together and how you assemble it in case you want to build one of your own. So here's one of these pulleys taken apart so we can look at how it actually works. You print up these three parts. You got the pulley and these two forks that go together to make the joint. Let's start with the pulley. The pulley's got a little trolley for adjusting the cable, and the cables pass over the top of the pulley and then through these little channels here. So there's a little channel there that the cable goes through. It then comes up and goes through that channel and then through the trolley here with a crimp on the end to stop it from going back through. And the same thing with the other cable. It goes over through the channel, through the channel, through the trolley, and then both the cables are here. And when you tighten this bolt, you pull the tension on the cables. It's a nice little trick. So you print this pulley upright like that, and you print these forks upright like that, with the layers going this way. This one's pretty simple, the smaller one that the pulley goes into. The larger one is a little more complicated. It's got a place to put two steel pulleys inside there, and those are to guide the cable, and use a bolt for each of those, lock them in place. This arm has a hollow channel, so you print it upright this way, and the top is peaked intentionally so that it doesn't require any supports and is nice and clean and ready for your cables. The pulley goes into the smaller of the two forks, and the trolley kicks off at a kind of 45 degree angle facing out. So I'm going to line that up, and I need to put a bolt in that first hole there. There we go. That just locks it in on the back. It'll still move there, so make sure that hole's lined up. Then take the second half of this thing, slide it there. Those are going to line up. And there we go. We've got the joint as it operates. You can see the cables are going to be passed through the end here. We're going to use the pulleys to get up, these little steel pulleys to get up onto this big pulley, and we're going to pass everything through the trolley, and we're going to crimp it there. So let me demonstrate that. So now the thing to do is you got to have enough cable to cover the thing that you're trying to build. So I want it to be in two parts because I want to be able to rotate it and do all the stupid stuff you see me doing. So I've got these two pieces of square channel that the cables are going to pass through, but what I really care about is that this overall length is going to be handled by these cables. So I've measured them by wrapping them kind of around the pulley here just to kind of come back on itself and maybe cut it here, and then the same thing on the other side, giving me some extra slack. So, plenty of cable to come all the way up through here, go around and through the little channels, plus a little extra. I find with this braided steel cable, if the wires start to fray, it's impossible for you to get it through any of the small channels that you need to do. So I just take a glue gun and I'm going to shove this piece of steel cable into the end of my glue gun there, and I'm going to goop up a little bit of extra glue, blep. And then I'm going to wipe off all that excess with a paper towel. And now this steel cable has got just a thin coat of hot glue along the end there to make it easy to thread it through all those little holes. Because of the wonderful things he does. So, Now I've got to pass these cables through this channel and get them over and around the pulley. I'm just going to do them one at a time. Consider using the pulley to help get it moving in a certain, get the cable moving in a certain direction. There we go. Got one sticking out one side. Got one sticking out the other side. I got my two cables. Now I'm going to take one of these and pass it over the top of the pulley, around, and I'm going to move the pulley until I can see the little channel that I need to pass this wire through. And what I need to do is take this wire, pass it through this small channel hole, then through that small channel hole, and then out the other side of this trolley, which adjusts the tension and allows us to take up the slack in the system after it's been installed. You can see the cable coming out the trolley there. There we go. Over the top of the pulley, through the channel, through that channel, out the back of the trolley. Let's do the other side.
My pause is too hard to do, so I'm recording.
And don't be afraid to use a pair of needle nose pliers to grab a hold of that and help get that wire moving through there. I've got both wires coming through the channel here, and each of them is going to one side over the pulley and entering the channel on the opposite side. So now I can put crimps and secure the ends of these wires so they don't pull through. I'm going to use one of these little aluminum crimp beads. Now each of those wires is crimped, and when I pull these wires from the channel, you're going to see those are going to slide back and seat themselves on the trolley there, nice and secure. And when I pull one wire, it moves one way, pull the other wire, moves the other way. Works nicely. Now that I've got this through here, my next job is to pass the wires through both pieces of square channel and then around the other pulley. So, just make sure when you get to the other side that the longer cable has the longer trip to make to get to its wire channel back here, and that the shorter cable has the shorter trip to make to get to its wire channel here, and then you'll end up with them being parallel. Okay, I've got everything threaded through. The first side is already crimped, and those crimps are up against the trolley, and it's fully extended there. I've got the cables running down the center channel. They're over this second pulley and around. Both pieces are parallel, right? These joints are in line as closely as I can get them, because when I crimp this other side, if it's off at all, then that's going to be kind of baked into the links of the cables. So you want to make sure that this thing is parallel when you've got the cables both the same length and measured. Because the trolleys are all the way extended into the pulleys, they have their full length to travel to make up slack. So I don't need to crimp these up against the trolley where it would be difficult to crimp them anyway. Instead, I'm going to crimp them here at the outside of the rim of the wheel, and then I'll make up the slack by adjusting both of the trolleys after I've finished. And you can see I've lined up both of the crimp beads here just with the inside of the rim there, and now I've got that extra slack that I've got to make up. And you can see the whole thing is quite a bit goofy if I try to move it. there's a lot, just a lot of slack in the system. There's a lot of bagginess. You can see the cable there puffs out because of the amount of slack in the system. So we're gonna have to tighten that up. Let's start with this trolley here. And I'm just gonna wind it out, and you can see the trolley moving towards the rim and pulling up that slack. And then just flip this bad boy around and do the other side here. Let's adjust this one up, pulling up the slack. Okay, that's all assembled. I got two different pulleys with cable drives connecting them. I'm gonna put the files in the description. That way you can download and print up your own. Leave any comments if you got them. Please mash those buttons, and I'll see you next time. I don't know.